2016, 22nd yeah, of May.
To this date.
To this date.
She has never been with your son.
Not only been, seen him.
Your wife has not seen your son for how long?
From
six
that
years,
date.
Almost 6 years.
Yes.
Wow.
She was involved in a faraway relationship, quietly. Still in marriage. Those are things I discovered later. She acknowledged that she actually was related with someone.
She acknowledged she was seeing someone? How was that like for you to hear?
As a believer, I was encouraged to forgive her.
Yeah?
And of course I had to. And I forgave her. And she came in.
And you took her back?
Yeah.
Hey? Okay. Hello and a warm welcome to Tuko Talks. My name is Lynn Ngugi. Now make no mistake, my guest today is a great fan of this show. But he's also the type that will write you a message on Twitter and tell you, Lynn, I love your stories, but you rarely feature stories of single dads and they're also going through a lot. And I looked at my show and I'm like, ni ukweli, I rarely feature these stories, but I always tell you, ee show ni yetu. So I'm also learning in the process. And today he's about to share his story that will definitely challenge you. I met his boy, an incredible, intelligent young man, and I cannot wait for you guys to hear his story. And so without further ado, please allow me to let him introduce himself. Hello, hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good.
Please introduce yourself.
My name is Simon.
Yeah.
And thank you so much for having me in your show.
Yeah.
Yes.
Karibu sana.
Asante.
Umesema Tuko Talks, lazima wa baba wakwe represented.
Of course, yes.
Why?
I'm excited.
Yeah.
And one thing that I appreciate and thank God and Tuko Show is because you have provided a platform. And this platform has been an inspiring platform to so many people.
Yeah.
Encouraging people and building people.
Yes.
And I believe and hope that also my story.
Yeah.
Would be something that you encourage and build other people,
even
as they learn.
As they learn, you are raising an intelligent young man.
Oh, thank you.
Can I even tell my audience the kind of fun we've had with him in the morning?
No before? Problem. You're free.
We've had so much fun. He's intelligent. He challenged me. And I think he's a reflection of what you've raised him to be.
Yeah.
I don't think he would be who he is without your contribution in his life. Mm. So, Simon, maybe take us through your story and how you ended up being a single dad of an 8-year-old.
Mine is a long story.
Yes.
But we will share and I will share what we can share for now.
Okay.
Yeah. I, as I've said, I am Simon, born in a family of four. I'm the first born in our family. And right behind me are three wonderful, beautiful ladies.
Okay.
Way back in 2009, that's when I was in my way to get into marriage. And I was believing God. And it happened that I met this lady.
Yeah.
And as things go, we fell in love.
Mm-hmm. What was it about her that made you be like, this is the one I'll say I do too?
I am a very intentional person in what I do.
Mm-hmm.
And having the knowledge of what I want in life and my pursuit in life, I was looking for someone who can be with me, help me fulfill my assignment in life. And that's how we began.
Mm-hmm.
After we met, I was very clear and of what I was pursuing in life and what I'm pursuing in life. And she agreed. After 2 years, that was 2010, 2011, 2012, we got married. Yes.
Wow, you had a church wedding?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So this was it for you?
It was.
All right.
Yes.
Okay, then what happened?
When we met, we didn't immediately have that close, intimate communication.
Mm-hmm.
After around a year, that's again when we came together and we rekindled the conversation.
Mm-hmm.
So in 2011, that's now when again, around May, that's now when we again our greed. And we killed the thing. And by the end of that year, that's now we made a decision now to settle. It was clear that now we are on the same path.
Okay.
So in 2014, to be precise of April, we got married.
Okay, so you guys, do you think you had taken enough time to know her? Do you think maybe it was just the heat of the moment that you said, let me settle down?
Not really. I believe that everything was clear, because what I shared and what she shared with me, to some good degree, we agreed. And there was it was not really an emotional kind of a thing. Much as emotions are involved in this matter,
yeah,
we had reached a point where we knew that this is a thing. And having come from a good background, and that is in our faith, and from our side as well, we thought that that is the thing, and it was clear that now we can settle.
Okay, yes. So you moved in together.
Yes.
Was she the same person you were dating as the same person? Because I hear people change. After marriage, you think this person will still be the same person I'm dating, and then after marriage, people kind of change. Was she the same person? Were you the same person too?
I believe that when people come together, there is what they want to pursue in marriage, because every marriage has to achieve a certain purpose.
Good.
So after sharing our, I call it a strategic divine plan of what we want to pursue in life, she was in agreement to it. And I looked forward for us to pursue life, work, and raise a family
together
with the ideals that we had agreed together. But later, after almost a year, things began changing. And that's where I was really puzzled, really what really happened, or what really took place, that now I'm seeing some changes. So from there on, from the very towards the end of first year, things began changing, and it was really a strain for the second year. Yes.
What are these things we are talking about? Alianza kuweka chakula chumvi mingi ama?
Sio mambo na chumvi nyingi. You know, I've said, and I will say this again, that the things that break relationships and marriages are not the big, big things. The simple, basic things are the main things in relationships and marriage. Things about communication, things about keeping to your agreement. For instance, if you agree this is the path that we are going to take, or this is how we're going to raise our children, I think we should stick to that. If we agree this is how we're going to fashion our spiritual lives, I believe that that's what we should pursue. If we agree this is what how we're going to run our business, I believe things do alter, and these things are not at times cast on stone. They can be altered, they can change. But at least we should be together and in agreement. So those are the things that actually began changing, and especially the very basic things in marriage, which I personally believe that there are some things that are so basic that the moment you see a crack, then it cannot stand.
For those of you who have been following us for a while, you know how I feel about growth and self-motivation. You always need to seize the opportunity and learn beyond your current capabilities. Even when you look at some of our previous guests at Inspire Kenya, whether we are talking about Njiru Mkombozi, the man who has built an entire city, or Dan, the guy who scored a D-, was employed, bought the business from the employer, and is now operating 7 businesses, you can tell the all built these businesses from scratch, and they are making a living from it, and they are incredibly driven individuals. And that's why when Wingu Digital Training offered to sponsor this episode, it was so easy to say yes to this partnership. Their online coaching programs offer a way to learn skills that will help you earn online while working from home, which is really valuable, especially given these times. You can either earn a full-time income or an extra extra income to complement your salary. You know, guys, it always pays to invest in yourself, and Wingu's premium training offers you 4 incredible high-quality courses, that is professional article writing, data entry, transcription plus captioning, and affiliate marketing and SEO training. Their courses are designed to fully equip you with the skills you need to consistently make money online, and they are tailor-made to fit the Kenyan market. And now, if you want to learn more about Wingu digital training and making money online, sign up to their free webinar training. The links are in the description. Please enroll and start your journey to successfully making money online. Bye. There are some people who say that if you see a woman walking out of a man na amemwachia mtoto, jua huyo mwanaume lazima alifanyia kitu huyo mwanamke. What did you do? And I mean this jokingly.
Yeah,
because
I
get tired of that question.
I know, and I've heard that several.
Yes. Yeah.
In fact, so many people for the last quite a number of, around 5 years now,
yeah,
they've been telling me, mwanamke haizi amka tu akaenda. Kuna chenye ulimfanyia nini? And especially my close friends, there are people who are so, you know, bright. Right away they would just be blunt and tell you there is something that you did. And this is what I would say. If you are on a race, and I would say a marathon or 100 meter dash, you can't change your lane. You have to stick to your lane. And marriage being a covenant, each person has their own role. There's a lane that you should follow. The moment one leaves their lane, then that thing cannot hold. And that's even how God has fashioned this thing about marriage. He holds onto his side, you hold onto your line.
Yeah.
And the very moment you leave your side, because him, he does not leave his lane, does it. So a covenant of marriage, the covenant of marriage, it is about you keeping to what you've agreed. And that's the reason why I believe that she didn't keep to our agreement. I would say this. I would not say that she, because this might come later in what I'm saying. She was not living an immoral life. She was not, we didn't have physical fights, so to say. But there are things that we could agree, and then she would not do. She would outrightly not do, in a very, I would say, stubborn and arrogant way. Yeah.
Was she abusive towards you?
Oh, not really. Yeah.
So I am, because my audience will, you see, they will want to know what is this thing that she did that made you decide, this woman is not for me anymore.
May I say this?
Yes.
I didn't chase her. I didn't chase her.
She walked out.
She walked out. She walked out. And this is what happened. Her mom passed on in 2013.
Yes.
That is 1 year after our marriage. So after that, 2013, the same year, Chosen was born. So it was really an emotional year for us. So after the birth of Chosen, it was now 2014, when we were raising our kid towards December. The issues that I used to see before the mom passed on, I think they escalated, because at some point we used to share, and I think because of the respect of our mother, she could hold down. So after that, I believe that's when she decided I can live my life. But now, there was something that was happening. I think she was involved in a faraway relationship, quietly, still in marriage. Those are things I discovered later.
Oh.
Yes. Later.
Okay.
So in December of 2014, we say that I tell her, now there are some things that we've not been agreeing upon and with, and I would like us to actually now share them, open up and see how we can resettle these matters. So she goes into a countryside. Actually, I told her, you go to your to her mom's side. I'll be visiting after 1 week. When I told her that, she didn't go. She went other ways.
Only for you to find out now later.
Later, maybe. Actually, when she went,
yeah,
I could not even reach her. She was off.
She left this, her, your son?
No, she went with the son.
She went with the son. Young, how old was the son here?
He was 1 year, exactly.
He was 1 year. Yes. Okay.
So when she went in 2014 December, we went to 2015. Within 1 month, I was able to locate her. I was able to visit. And I told her, hey, we need to settle these things now, the two of us. Mm. Because I realized, oh, kumbe, it was just to become this. Because she even didn't go to her mom's or where she was, she's born. Mm. So she went into her aunt's side, mm-hmm. and which is against. Unlike when you want to settle matters, you don't go to other places. You go to your own area where you can go sit down with the elders and perhaps with people and settle the matters. So when I located her, I said, told her, hey, we need to settle these matters between me and you. Because I have seen that they may escalate. She was not willing and ready. She was not. I did that in January, February, March, April, May, June, July. Now, in May, in April, in May, June and July, I involved other people. A thing that we had discussed earlier that we should not discuss our matters and settle things with other people. So I feel that, hey, maybe there's something that I'm not doing right. Let me involve other people, elders, my kinsmen, spiritual leaders. But things, she was not ready and willing. Yeah.
Okay.
From our end, it was why? She would not give reason. No reason. She gave no reason.
Do you think she was fed up with you?
She can answer that best.
If she was fed up.
Yeah, if she was fed up.
Yeah.
But she made it clear that she's not ready to be back with me. And that later she said that she feels that she should get married to another person. That was before many witnesses, not once, not twice. Yeah, in these our meetings, because we had quite a number, around how many meetings? More than five meetings. And she said that she's not willing.
Okay.
And she was not giving any clear reason.
Yeah.
Now, later I realized that she was in a relationship. But after she left now, my place. That's the reason why she was not willing to.
Oh, so she was already entangled with another person.
That is the thing.
Let's talk about your son. Mm. At what point now did it reach that you realized, me and this woman, we are done, but we have a baby. How do we now bring up this baby together? And was she present?
After she left, the July of 2015, I told her, let me just come visit and see my son. By then she was far in Mombasa.
And you're in Nairobi?
I'm in Nairobi. So when I told her, she told me, no, I'll come to Nairobi. And she came. That was the last week of August 2015. When she came, we talked and she said, all, I'm sorry, I'm ready now to come back. Let's build our marriage. Yeah.
Why change of heart?
I don't know. And she didn't say that before me. When she came, we had at least some elders. And there we prayed together. And she said that I'm ready, I'm sorry for everything. And she acknowledged that she actually was related with someone.
She acknowledged she was seeing someone? How was that like for you to hear?
As a believer, I was encouraged to forgive her.
Yeah.
And of course I had to. And I forgave her. And she came in.
And you took her back?
Yeah.
Hey? Okay.
So after 1 week, she came on a Thursday. The following week, on a Friday evening, no, Saturday morning, she told me, I want to leave and go. I had just come to bring you your son.
This
she
is
had
after...
lived with my son for 7 months. So now she tells me, I just come to bring your son. I told her, no way. I remember very well that day I didn't go to work. I didn't go to work. I tried to persuade her, seek to know what is the reason. And you know, in that 1 week, you were trying to do the best so that you can retain this thing, you know?
You were excited to have your family back.
Oh, yes. There's no one who marries Lynn with an intent to separate. leave alone divorce. Any intentional person who is serious and like me, I was not married to separate or divorce. So this was a moment I had to forgive so that I can retain and we would for us to build our marriage. So in telling me that, that evening we had another meeting again where we were the previous week so that we may know what is happening, what did I do wrong? I was actually seeking to know what in this 1 week, what have I not done right that you are trying to see if there is any change and I've not changed. So it was like a pleading that night. What really did I not do right? Please let me know. But it never happened. She was determined. In fact, she said that I am determined. I just want to go. Yeah. And she left that morning.
How old was your son here?
He was 1 year, 8 months.
1 year, 8 months. She left your son with
you? She left that very morning. After our conversation, the whole almost the whole night.
Yeah.
And she went. And now, mind you, I was not alone when she said that. It's a decision she made before my relatives. And yeah, at least, yeah. It's a decision that she made before people.
And she left now your son?
She left.
And this is now where the journey between That's you where and now the son begins?
That's the journey between me and my son began.
1 year, 8 months.
Yes.
He's almost 8.
Yeah, just, yeah, he, now, as we talk now, he'll be turning 8 years this year. In December 14th.
So these are like 6 years.
Yeah,
of
I've
you
been
and
with my son,
son
for 6 years.
Wow.
Now after that she came again. This 2015. So 2016 of Feb, she came back, pleaded, and I was required to again take her back.
Aye. Kwan, even you are also not feeling sorry for yourself, like this woman has come and she has said she was in a relationship, she has left my son, she's coming back. It's even you move on.
You don't just move on. Mind you, when you are left with a son and you are alone and you are a man. One, during that period between September and Feb when she came, is the time I was trying to recollect and know how to
be a single dad.
Yeah, attend to my son. Well, I was excited. But at the same time, it was very challenging. I've never had a challenging time.
Talk to me about that part.
Then that period between September and Feb of 2016, around 6-7 months, it was really something. I remember I used to take time before I leave and prepare my son. I would take an hour to prepare him, you know? And then, thank God for one particular woman who took, who actually, she knew me and she told me, don't ever be worried. While you're going to work, you can leave my son. Actually, she had a place whereby she was taking care of other kids. But not
care?
Really, really kids.
Yeah.
Grown-ups.
Okay.
Ladies and some guys who had not finished their school. She would take them and take them back to school, like in secondary, take them to college.
Okay.
So now my son found a place. He was just the child. So that was a nice environment for him. So that's where I used to leave him.
Mm-hmm.
But I would leave him in the morning around 9. Then at 4 or 5, I would pick him. Actually, my life was cut. My I would say my social life was really interfered with. I could not meet anyone. I could not attend anything. My focus was now being with my son and finding my way around on how to attend to him. Yes. And that's why, even through that, I also learned something. And that's about single parents and especially single mothers. That's how I discovered what they go through. How hectic, and especially if one is working and employed, it is something not easy. Yeah, it is not an easy thing. Yeah, to a self-employed person, you can adjust yourself and plan. But to someone who is employed, it is something.
Yeah.
And I have respect, too much respect for single mothers who have their children and they are employed. It is a toll.
Yeah.
It is a serious toll on them. Yeah.
Emotionally, how are you?
I was left at a state. I won't say I was depressed. I can't say that I was stressed. I had some joy, too much joy that I was with my son. And he's with me. But at the same time, the challenge is the challenge was working and managing in attending to him. Mm. There was a serious challenge on that. Mm. And yet he's a very little tiny child. Okay? There are some things he cannot express. Mm. So it is up to me to know, basically attend to his holistic life.
Mm.
Yeah.
Is he not asking you questions like, Dad, where is mom?
No, he never used to ask that question. What I did and what I've done all through, it is to love this boy. When you love someone and love them totally, there is no void left to question some things. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
From a little child to a grown up, when you love them proper and love them fully, there is no void left to ask some questions.
Mm.
And that's how, if you oppress a child or you don't show love to a child,
mm-hmm.
then that void and questions will arise because there's something they are lacking. But when you provide that and fill that void, then a child will be fulfilled.
You have now full custody of your son.
Yes.
And you are legally divorced.
Yes.
When did it come? You know, you got to that point where you are like, okay, I will not chase this woman again. Let's just divorce. Let's just talk custody and we move on.
Okay, when she, the second time she came,
she
stayed for around 3 months.
Uh-huh.
Now, in those 3 months, that's when I also discovered that she has not changed and she was not determined to change. Because in the second coming, she promised that I'll change. And one particular individual, I respect that man, he told me, Simon, you know, he had actually taken responsibility and said, let her be in my place. He's a counselor. For 2 to 3 months, you'll be coming after 1 or 2 weeks, and then you'll be observing, we'll observe the change.
Mm.
That's what the wife said. So the man told me, that's a very good suggestion for my wife.
Mm.
But Simon, I would ask you a question. How are you able to observe change when your wife is in my house? So let her be in your house. Mm-hmm. You're the best person to observe the change that you want.
Mm.
And that's how I took her him the second time.
Mm.
Because I found that statement, a wise statement. So when I realized that she has not changed, na tabia ni zile zile, and that was actually, I will not go into details, but I discovered that she had not changed and she was still relating from two people.
Mm.
So that's when one particular morning, our grandfather had passed on. So I told her, before you travel home for the burial, we have to settle these matters. Because, of course, there were to be questions, we had to sit down and talk. So I told her, we can't just pretend. Let's settle things so that as we go to the parents, things are
settled.
All right and settled.
Mm.
The day that I said that, that's now when she left for good, to this very day. So I left, went to work. That evening, that gentleman, the counselor, was to come into our house because he told me, I want to visit,
mm-hmm.
let's come talk, because he was aware that we had lost our, of course, it was our grandfather from my in-laws.
Mm.
Our grandfather. So he told me, let me come, let's talk, and then see how we're going to do.
Mm.
When he said that, I think the guilt in her could not hold. I left work in the morning at around 9.
Mm.
At around 2, she called me,
mm-hmm.
and she told me that there are some things I want to hand over to someone, a relative, around 2. Then after around 30 minutes, my neighbor calls me and tells me, Simon, where are you? You know you are left with your child, and we are told that you'll be coming to attend to him. It is now around 3, and we have to go pick our children in school. Where are you, and who are we going to leave your child with? So that's when I realized that she had left. So I had to rush, and that was 22nd of May 2016, to this date.
Mm.
She's never, ever again been with my son.
2016. May.
May.
2016,
22nd of May.
To this date.
To this date.
She has never been with your son.
Not only been, seen him.
Your wife has not seen your son for how long?
From
six
that
years,
date.
Almost 6 years.
Yes.
Wow.
To this date. Now, after that is when she left Because I didn't chase her, you see? I didn't chase her.
Yeah.
There was no fight, nothing.
Mm.
And she just left for her own reasons. She can give her reasons. And she has never given a reason why she left on that day. So that's when I decided, now we will not keep on the push and pull.
Mm.
I have to make a decision. Mm. And I decided in my heart, not again. Yeah, we can't keep on pulling. I have a responsibility to raise my son.
Mm.
I have a responsibility to run my life. I have an assignment to pursue in life. I have a purpose that I need to fulfill.
Mm.
And I can't do it when someone is not present. And it's like you are seeking to jeopardize what we want to pursue. So if you are out, at least I'll have some focus.
Mm.
Let me focus on the son and what I have to do in our life.
Mm.
And that's now when I decided I am going to take an initiative.
Mm.
I went to the children's court. I received a letter. Of course, you can't stay with a child alone in an area and you don't have a document to show, because this is in the city.
Mm.
So who knows this is your child? So that's what I did. From there on, I was advised that I should get her legal custody. And of course, I wanted to do this because in my heart, after almost a year, I thought, if she has gone, I will need at some point to settle. Settling will mean that if someone comes into my life again, if I have to move on, then I need to have some ownership of my son.
Mm.
And legally, because I was actually legally married.
Mm.
So that's when I went to initiated the custody of my son.
Mm.
That was in 2017 now.
Yeah.
Now she had attempted to come back in 2017.
Mm.
She called and said that she wants to come visit the son. Kumbe, she wanted to come and forcefully take him. So it is May 1st of 2017. She visits.
Mm.
She calls and says that she's coming to visit.
Mm.
Kumbe, she had organized with her relatives to come and, I would say, abduct my son.
Mm.
So I presented my son in town to her because she has a right to see the son. Even to date, she has that right. So when she came, we had like 30, 45 minutes. And after that, she told me it was late in the evening, around 6. I want to buy him something in the supermarket. Walking out of the supermarket, around 100 meters from where we had met, the relative showed up from nowhere in the middle of town. Then there a scuffle ensued. It was drama. So they forcefully took him out of my hands, and I could not let it. So, you know, my son by then, he could not recognize her.
Mm.
So he cried until he lost his voice.
Mm.
And you know, we are pulling each other. We attracted crowds. And you know, in this city, people do not care to listen to anyone's case. In fact, I remember I just escaped some punches from these boda-boda guys. And women. Women were on my case. When do you remember mtoto? Umeiba mtoto? Hmm? Umeiba mtoto? Then a crowd milled. And you know, now they were not expecting this. So one of the relatives is a policeman. He said, he was one of them. He said, stop, I'm a policeman. So the crowd now calmed.
Mm.
When he said that, the crowd is asking me, who are you? This guy is, just let him into our hands. We want to deal with him. So he said, I'm a policeman, I know this man. I was asked, do you know him? I said, yes, I know him. Who is he? I said, he's my, like my father-in-law, because he's a uncle.
Mm.
And what is happening? Because the child was crying, calling daddy, he didn't know another person. They said, the child is calling daddy.
Mm. Who is daddy here?
Who is, so, yeah, now they had to calm down because a voice of reason. If he's calling, he must, the child must be knowing this man.
Mm.
He is truly, must be the dad.
Mm.
So in 5-10 minutes, actually 5 minutes, I was able to explain. And guy said, maneno ya familia. Mm-hmm. So this guy, when he said that, some wise men in the midst said, we will not let them go with you. They took my conducts, they took their conducts, and they told them, produce your IDs as policemen. And they took the photos. And they took the car that they had photos, and they told me, now go, it is safe. In case anything happens, we have all the details.
Mm.
So that's now we went to the police station. Mm. Of course, on that particular day, I didn't have my son that day. He actually spent in the police station, my son. he's spent in a police station. Mm. And apparently the police station, that's where one of these uncles works. Mm. So it was safe. So the following day, it was a weekend and an holiday actually. So I remember it was on a Sunday and then it mailed to the, it was an holiday, on Monday it was still an holiday. Mm. So we could not attend to the court because you remember I initiated a court process.
Yes.
So on Tuesday, that's when now we visited
the court.
And I was told, continue keeping your son until the case is over. Yeah, they have to give a strong reason why they feel that they should come and take the child to the court. So I think that really demoralized them and they realized they had to think again about their strategy. Mm. And in 2019, the court settled the case about my custody and I was given full custody of my son.
Full custody?
Yes.
Was any visitation rights for her? And you've said she's not seen the son, so if there are any visitation rights, why is she not coming to see the son?
Now, when this happened, the abduction thing, my lawyer gave restraining orders to them because this was considered a threat, not only to me, but to the child as well. They call it child-parent abduction. Mm. So because of that, she was given a restraining order.
Okay.
So she could not visit. Mm. She couldn't visit until the case is decided. So during that period, I also took initiative of my life because when people behave that way, your life also is not safe. You are in danger. Mm. I had to be careful about my life and my son.
Mm.
Yeah, because you don't know what people are planning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And where you live.
Yeah, and where I live as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Does it hurt you that she still won't even see your son even for an hour?
Hurt me? I would say no. Perhaps her. She may be hurt. But she caused the hurt. I didn't cause it. Because from the onset, if I was a bad person, I would not present the son to him. She had a right. She has a right to visit the son. She still has a right even to date because she was given that right by the court.
Mm.
And as a parent, you know the child does not belong to you. The child belongs to both of you. And it's your responsibility to take care of the child.
Mm.
And in case you're not able, that's when the government takes over. And they take care, because it shows that perhaps you're mad or you are a danger to the child.
Mm.
That's now. But she proved to be a danger through abduction.
Abduction.
Yes.
Yeah.
And also to me, and I'm the one who was keeping the son. So the court did not find any reason to deny me the right to. So it is upon her. It does not really, really per se hurt me. But if she calls and seeks to see the son, as it was decided, and actually before her presence, she agreed.
Yeah.
She can visit the son anytime she wants. But in a police station or in a children's court compound, that is what was, and she agreed to it.
Let me, in most cases, it's men who will leave their wives and start another family and not even look back.
That's true.
Has she started another family also? Do you think she started another family? Does she has other children?
I am not aware if she did. But what I'm sure and certain is that she has another child.
Oh.
Yeah. Because during the court session, she used to attend with us more for 6 months child, around that age. Yeah, before the custody, the end of the case. Yeah.
So
that one I'm certain.
She has another child.
Yeah, so that tells you a lot.
That tells me a lot. It tells us a lot.
Yeah.
Obviously, it tells us a lot. What do you think has helped you to be a good dad?
I can't say that I'm a good dad. But I can say that I'm seeking to be the best that I can. I want to be a dad that my son would proudly say, this is the dad that I wish to have. I wish to have. I have a dad that I wish to have. And that is actually born from my upbringing, my faith in God, and what I would really love to see, not only in my child, but to any other child that is born.
Do you think it was a mistake for you to let in someone after they confessed to having cheated in your marriage?
Nothing happens by mistake.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, everything happens with the purpose and the plan of God. While I was growing up, while I was young and growing up, a young man, I'm not old, I'm still
young. You're still young, aye. Yes.
I have this belief system,
yeah,
that a man should take responsibility. You know, we have so many in our generation and time and day, not only in our nation, but the world over, we have a fatherless kind of a generation. I'm not trying to give a cloud cover that we are fathers who are irresponsible. We are very intentional fathers. So many of them. Men who are committed to bring up their children.
Mm-hmm.
Men who have given their whole, yeah, to make sure that they have given their whole, their resources, their knowledge, everything to make sure that their children are grown. Okay? And they grow to be who God created them to be. So I want to believe that because of that desire that I had while I was growing up, having being brought up by a single mom and a grandmother who was very wise, I draw a lot from those two women, and they have molded some of my values,
yeah,
and beliefs. And this has been more emboldened by the word of God that I know, that of who a father is. So I am not hurt. I would really be hurt if I was insufficient in anything. I do not have all, but at least I have some knowledge on how I should bring up my son. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So that gives me a lot of calmness,
yeah,
and boldness, and I'm relaxed and at ease bringing up my son.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Not because I do not need another person, or I feel so sufficient on my own,
yeah,
but no, at least I have some knowledge,
yes,
so far, that and I know what to do to some extent to make sure that my son, and of course you've seen,
yes,
he grows to be a man that he should be.
Brilliant kid.
Yes.
Brilliant. Has Simon moved on also? Is he seen someone? Has he also tried to be like, you know, I was married, it did not work, but I know I'm a good man and I can get a good woman?
I wouldn't say that I've been alone. I have not related, so to say.
Yes.
I have related twice. Well, the ones that you say, these are serious relationships.
Oh, okay.
Wacha hizi za kukunywa kahawa mingi.
Hapa.
Hapa na kule. And these have been two that happened, but they seemingly, I mean the last, seemingly,
yeah,
look as though Corona interfered with a lot of things.
Oh!
Yeah, so currently, I am believing God.
You are believing God for a miracle. You are believing God for me.
That is enough. Believing God.
Yes. Oh. You are believing God for a wife. Simon is believing God for a wife, my people. So, to you right now,
yes,
because I know you've learnt a lot.
Yes, yes.
What do you look for in a woman?
I have actually explained this not once, not twice.
Yes.
And those questions have been asked.
Mm.
But I find that many times when I express what I believe in a woman,
yeah,
or what I should expect in a woman, yeah, or what I'm looking in,
yeah,
a woman,
yeah,
it at times sounds a little, let's say, difficult or controversial or something like that.
Let's say it. We'll rate it right here. Our audience will help us rate this one. Let's see if it's controversial, difficult. Yes. They're intelligent.
But simply put,
yes,
very intelligent humans.
Okay.
I would really want to have a woman who will not compliment, but an helper. That's it.
A helper.
Yeah. I think that sums all. And an helper must be godly. Godly in the sense of godliness. Not a cliche that we always say that I want a godly man, a godly woman. No. In its tenet, and it's the meaning of that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Godliness is my number one.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. That should be, the rest we can work on.
Yeah.
And you know, when someone is godly, God will counsel you. God will, he will actually prune you. There are some things he will instruct you on his own. if you're a godly woman, there are some things he will tell you, this you should not do. A man should not at times and always be telling you, I don't want to, hiya inipendezi. No. When you have God, we have a counselor. The Holy Spirit is a counselor. Yes. He counsels you. Yes. He knows, he tells you what you need to do, what you ought to say, how you ought to behave, live, you know. When you have God, you have everything.
You have
so
everything.
That's a woman that, an helper who is godly. That sums it all.
That's the one you are praying for.
I prayed for.
Amen.
So I'm just thanking God.
You are just thanking God for her. Krisha, you are just thanking God for her.
Yes.
Yeah? Do you think we as a society, we don't care so much about what single dads are going through?
I know there are so many single dads. They have appeared even in your show. And one thing that I have seen, we have measured, I think it's because of the empowerment of the girl child. And we so much lean on the single women, which we should. Because I've come to know, out of experience, that single ladies and single moms, to be precise, go through a lot. I will be not the last person to judge, but I will not even appear anywhere to judge a single mama. It is so wrong. She carries a lot. She carries not only the role of a father, but there is too much baggage that people do not see, and they judge her so harshly. A single lady will be judged and be told that, and especially when she appears before married men, huyu atachukua mwanaume wako, both in and out of the church. They receive some serious judgment. So those are people that I respect so, so much. I honor them, I salute them. They are not only super, there's no definition. They do a lot. And I've always said I prefer men being single dads than a single woman.
Why?
Wanaume, men will find their way. You know, when a lady calls you and she tells you that she, and she's a single mom, the first thing that will click is this woman anataka maneno yangu. And she's genuinely seeking for help. And a man will turn that. You see, they are more vulnerable than men. Yeah.
And most people take advantage.
Men are not that vulnerable like women. So
yeah.
Single dads, they have challenges. Yes, we have got our challenges. But it is actually, that's why most of them are never, it's never a major thing. And they are there, but no one really puts some focus on them. Because wanaume ujikaza. Mwanaume atajikaza, lakini mwanamke, of course, God says that they are weaker vessels. They will always break and break down. Yeah, so whenever and wherever you see a single mother, there was a presence of man. Because she can't be a single mother without a man. Where is he? We have so many men whose desire is just to sire, but they are not ready to be fathers. They are failing their responsibility of being dads. And I am so proud. And I thank God that he saw it fit. Actually, I wouldn't say that I want this thing. God saw it fit. And that has been born by the desire. I used to tell you that I used to say, ukiwa we ni mwanaume na umepata mtoto, take responsibility. Hata kama you're not present, really present physically in that family, just take responsibility over your child. So the to answer your question on the challenges that we go as single dads, whatever a single mother goes through,
a single dad is going through.
Yeah, but as we have, people always wonder, I think that is very serious now. Why, where is, because I'll give an example. Whenever I'm looking for an house, when I'm checking for to move into an house, they'll be asked, now, mama mtoto yuko wapi? I think that is the first question that I'm ever asked. It doesn't go well with me. Well, I always respond in a good way. Yeah, why are you concerned about the mother? The father is present. Yeah. I am present. So, not in a rude way,
but
I don't think that is the right question to ask me. Because a single mother will rarely be asked that question. But a man will be asked. I think it would be a concern. I know it's a concern because society has been meant to think it's like there's a right. It's okay to have single mothers.
And it's not okay.
It's not okay to have single dads. Mm. Mm. Yes, it happens. Not it's not anyone's wish to be a single dad or a single mother. But it happened. Yeah, it happened. Mm-hmm. And when it happens, you have to take it.
Yeah.
And as a man who, if you are purposed, if you are very deliberate and intentional, you take responsibility and bring up that child.
Mm.
I am not alone. We are many. And we are doing it by the grace of God.
Amen.
Yeah. And we are going to raise up a generation that is holistic.
Mm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Fine in every other way.
Yes.
Yeah. Fine in every other
Fine
way.
Fine in every other.
Yes. The challenges are there. Mm. They have been there.
Mm.
In every way. Spiritual, social, financial, material, you know. And also to attend to the child. As they grow, they grow with challenges.
Mm.
And they will challenge you in many other areas.
Yeah.
As they grow, at every stage,
yes,
there is a challenge.
Yeah.
But to a person, I always say that God is gracious because he always help you find a way out.
Yes. Have you had a conversation with your son in regards to the mom? Like, have you sat him and told him?
Mm.
Other kids, when you see their mom, there's a reason your mom is not here. Have you had that conversation?
We've had.
Mm.
One time, when my son was in, was it PP1?
Mm-hmm.
After baby class.
Mm.
Yeah, picking him from school, he told me, Daddy, we were in the morning, I was taking him to school.
Mm.
He told me, Daddy, when do you want to go to school? Lakini watoto wale wengine wote wanachukuliwa na mama zao. Ni mimi tu nachukuliwa na daddy. Sinanga mama.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the first time I struck that conversation. So this is what I have prepared myself always.
Mm.
It's like I have always prepared myself to have a response and strike a response whenever my son raises a question in regard to the mother.
Mm.
So I always find it a good time
to start
the conversation.
Yes.
So I break it down to his understanding.
Yeah.
Or now he can understand.
As he grows. Okay.
So that's how we do things. And we speak, we are very open with my son. We speak about everything.
Mm.
Spirituality.
Mm.
I remember the other day he asked me about sex. What is sex, Daddy?
Oh.
And we struck that conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm.
We do it very openly.
Yeah.
He asks me very hard questions, and the moment he asks, always that is the moment.
Let's have this conversation.
So we have it. Whenever he asks me, I don't jump into it.
Mm.
I always say thank you.
Mm.
The best moment, I'll tell him, just give me some time, I explain to you. Or very early morning,
yeah,
we will begin the conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
When he watches this episode, because he will grow up and one day he will see Dad on this episode, what would you want him to know?
Truth has no apologies, Lynn. Speak the truth fluently. Yeah.
I love that.
Never ever lie to your son or your daughter.
Yes.
Tell them the truth. Because if you do not know, if they discover the truth, even when he was coming here, we had a conversation in the evening.
Yes.
And he knew. He told me, yeah, go tell your story. He has a few things that he knows about my story at his age and at his stage. So I will always share the truth. Because eventually, if I do not tell him, he will know it from people. It will be much more better that he hears it from me, not from another person.
Mm.
And I'm so proud of that.
Mm.
Yeah. Wow. I'll always tell him the truth.
Mm-hmm.
Truth, not to castigate the mother. I'll always uphold her. And I will always tell him the truth of what happened. He was not in the picture. He cannot, in any way, it should not affect him. Whatever happened between me and the mother should never ever affect or interfere with his upbringing.
Mm.
I'll do all what I can in my power and ability to make sure that my son does not and will never be affected by my story.
By your story.
Yes.
I love that.
Mm.
Truth has no apology.
Yeah. I don't remember any time Jesus Christ said, I'm sorry for what I've said.
Mm.
Never.
Nah.
Never.
You want to hear my version?
Yes,
there
please.
Is light in truth.
Oh, thank you.
That has always been my mantra.
Yes.
There is light in truth.
Mm.
It's either yes, no, or I don't know. You get it. There is so much light in truth. Before we go, is there anything you think we needed to talk about that we've not discussed?
So much.
Like what? You wanna do part two?
I just gave a brief of my story. Yeah. I actually didn't give details.
Yeah.
There's so much. But this is what I would say. I would really I really thank God for the opportunity and the platform. To share my story. I am not sharing this story to receive some oye.
No.
I've said that before.
Yes.
I am not seeking for sympathy. Christ has been sufficient. I'm not trying to say this because I need some kind of an help. I didn't come into your show because I need to have someone. If the person shows up, through or out of a result of this show, we thank God.
Amen.
But that is not the main purpose.
Yes.
Yeah, it is not. Mm. It was not meant to be.
Mm.
I want to encourage the single parents, single dads, single moms, that they are not alone. No matter what they are going through, there's a lot single parents go through. And people give some serious judgment, ignorantly, they judge them without hearing their story. Okay? So they should actually be encouraged. You can't put a sticker on your face to explain everything about and why you're a single dad or a single mom. Okay? God knows why it happened. It may have been as a result of death, some, others, their own mistakes. Others initiated, and others were very intentional. There are people who actually want to be single mothers by choice.
Yes.
There are others who, because I call them victims of circumstances, like myself. You just thank God.
Yes.
And take responsibility over that child or children. And know that you are not alone. Society may judge you as it has done before. Don't give up. Don't give in. Focus. Know that God, in His manifold wisdom, knew and allowed that into your life for a purpose. So bring that child as a whole child.
Yes.
My child lacks nothing in terms of, not that he has everything, but he should never ever feel that I'm not whole because my mom is not around. No. That is not allowed. I will not allow it. As much as God will help me, I will not really want that to happen. I want to bring up my child as a whole, confident, brave. I want to appreciate men and women who have stood with me all through, ever since I was left with my son. There are people who have truly worked with me, contributed their resources. I mean, calls, there are guys that would call me when I was with my son at the middle of the night to talk for hours to encourage me. There are people who offered to be left with my son because I am going to work far from town, you know, out of Nairobi, and I'll leave my son for 1 or 2 days. My very own relatives, my sisters, my cousins, and very other not bio people who have gone beyond what my family can do. To understand me and, you know, to stand with me in many areas.
Have you ever had a house help?
Never. If I bring in an house help, it won't go well. Yeah. After some time, you know, the society, not only society, if I bring someone in my house, one, it will not be understood. A few people understand. Huyu ni bibi ama ni mfanyikazi. And after some time, you know, I am human.
Siulete kijana.
Much as I'm spiritual. Yeah, I would have gladly done that. But I always wonder. And especially now, since I'm not employed, I'm self-employed. So I manage.
Very well.
Very well. The reason why I have never... Well, I have people work. At times when if I need some... someone to help in the house, you know, casual, they'll just come, do the clothes and go. Yeah, and that's it. That's how we've done it and run it.
Okay.
Yes. When my son was young, that's when I really needed someone to like be there. But that time has gone.
Mm.
He's now a responsible human.
Mm.
He does everything on his own.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
So I really wanted to appreciate people who have participated in my life.
Wow.
Yeah, there are people who have stood with me.
Mm.
Yeah. Emotionally, spiritually, and people who have stood, like during that time, there were guys who stood and counseled me.
Mm.
There are people who rebuked me sharply. The Kali sana, kwa ukali. You're not doing this right.
Mm.
Their decisions I've made, and they were not right decisions.
Mm-hmm.
And I learn. I've always said I have not failed in anything. I just learn.
All right. Yeah. All right. So, and today I want to challenge, especially men who are watching this show. If you are a man and you would want to share your story with me, my email is right here on the screen. Chebet is our editor. She will leave it right there. Feel free to send me a well-detailed brief of your story. Ama kama saimo, twende pale Twitter, munipate hapo Twitter, muniandikie DM, muniambie. Lynn, I want to also share my story even if I appreciate. You know, I appreciate genuine people and I appreciate people who are super authentic. Mm. So feel free to write me a well-detailed brief of your story so that we can share your story here on Tuko Talks. I want to do 10 special episodes dedicated to men and their stories because I believe it's our responsibility too here at this platform to make sure that we try to bring you as many stories as possible but also balance them at the same time. That's it for today. Wanna say a huge shout out to my amazing director, the legendary Edwin Ochieng. Ed, thank you so much for filming this show and giving us the best quality ever. And our amazing editor, Chebet, for editing this episode and making sure it reaches to you right on time. My name is Lynn Ngugi. We are almost Tuko karibu kufika 1 million subscribers. So my people, if you are watching this show and you have not subscribed, akimi nasikia vibaya, just click on that click hapo kwa subscribe to. Me, I want to make sure we are 1 million subscribers. That will really make me happy. So if you are watching and you've not subscribed, please subscribe. May God bless you. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you. Till next time. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.